All right, we are about 2 weeks into the new year now, and instead of dieting, some of you are taking part in something called Dry January. That is where you give up alcohol for the entire month. Well, some researchers say it can really help to jumpstart better drinking habits for several months, maybe the whole year, but it also creates some other changes. And here to talk to us more about it is Dr. Matthew Knight. And okay, so I think that one of the things that is interesting to me about this is that if you only do it for a month, but you don't make any lifestyle changes going forward, is it really doing any good?
Yeah, I mean, that's the criticism, is that you're going to do this boomerang diet thing where you don't do something, and then when February 1st rolls around, all of a sudden it's part-time.
Right.
That's not the idea. The idea is to assess your relationship with food, in some cases, or alcohol in this case, and see how it impacts your life. And when February 1st rolls around, maybe have a better attitude towards alcohol and the effect it has in your life. I mean, the reality of it is that a lot of Americans drink heavily. That's more than two drinks a day. And drinking heavily is associated with all kinds of nasty things. Cancers, decreased work productivity, up to $300 billion of our economy is attributed to alcohol-related work stoppages. You can get pancreatitis, you can get liver problems, you can get cancers, and it goes on and on and on. So the idea is, if you're drinking a little bit or a lot and you take a month off, you can reassess where you are, take that month, have perspective, realize you don't have to go to that cocktail party and have that beverage in order to be social.
Or just have one beverage. I mean, I think that we always talk about all things in moderation, and we talk, there are benefits of drinking red wine, but I think the problem is that we maybe imbibe a little too much.
Yeah, I mean, there's hundreds of articles showing that red wine has a positive effect on cholesterol and our lipids and our heart function, but there is just as much evidence to suggest that drinking has negative health effects, including breast cancer. And the problem is that it's all about habits. So take people who smoke, for instance. People get in their car and they smoke a cigarette, or they come home from a long day of work, and in order to relax, they have a cigarette. Well, alcohol tends to play that same role in people's lives, where they have one glass of wine with dinner, but then it becomes two, and then maybe it becomes three. And the idea behind this, and again, it started in England, where they drink way more than we do, was to take a step back, look at where you are, and hopefully after 31 days have a better relationship. And in a small group that they studied over there, they saw really crazy changes in the people that took that 31 days off. The 71% reduction in drinking the remainder of the year, and actually 10% of people stopped drinking altogether just by taking that 31 days off. Another cool thing they did is took two groups of people, and one group did it and one group didn't. This was like you guys, normal everyday people.
Yeah.
They worked at a magazine. And in the half that did it for that 31 days, they saw a 20% reduction in the fat in their liver, 15% improvement in their sleep and their work productivity, and a 20% reduction in their cholesterol just by stopping drinking for 31 days.
For 31. Mm-hmm. Okay. So y'all got to try it and let us know. Keep us posted.
Yeah. Let us know on Facebook how it's going out there. You're halfway through the month, though, so you got to do the whole 31 days.
Okay. So maybe you go through mid-February.
Yeah.
There you go. Through
That's
Valentine's Day. Dr. Knight, fascinating stuff. Thank
Thanks
you so
for
much
me.
For joining us this morning, as always.
Stay dry out there.
Yes.